Arrival was the first time ABBA had a successful album in America. They'd had occasional hits, but it wasn't consistent. When Arrival came out, they finally arrived, as it were, as an international class pop band, and it was a very modern sounding album.
Compare it, I suppose, to something like Revolver by the Beatles, where you know, the whole thing is of uniform quality.
When you think of the hits that ABBA were making, they were kind of works of art, and I think people underestimate pop music as an art. You know, there's lots of these kind of pop hits these days that you're not even going to be playing in 10 weeks, let alone 10 years.
It's their best and most consistent record from start to finish musically. It's got the diversity and it's got the cohesion, and I think it most represents as a unique studio album rather than a collection of greatest hits, precisely what ABBA were all about.
30 years since this album, and we're all still singing Naomi, You Know You, we're still singing Dancing Queen, so that's 30 years, and we'll still be playing Dancing Queen in 30 years from now. It doesn't date. Give me an ABBA song, Dancing Queen. Give me an ABBA album, Arrival.
I've got here the cover of the first album that they did when they first got together. Of course, they were in separate bands to start with. Originally, Benny was a member of a group called the Hep Stars, and I think the Hep Stars were more of a English-styled pop group. And Björn was a member of the Hootenanny Singers, and the Hootenanny Singers were a bit more folk. And I think really that what they planned to do and what they did achieve up until Arrival and beyond, of course, but was they wrote great pop songs, you know, and they encapsulated the 3-minute pop song.
They came along as a bit of a kind of novelty act, didn't they? From, you know, that band in Brighton in, what was it, 74? You know, the high heels, the kind of glittery gear. It was almost kind of like the next phase of glam rock from Sweet, Mud and bands like that. But they kind of grew up very quickly, and I think, especially people on the radio, they suddenly decided that this wasn't just a gimmick band. They were writing great 3-minute pop songs.